When the moon hits your eye like a bigger pizza pie, that's amore.
Are you gonna try the?
No, I don't think
I'm
that.
So
I'll
rack
the
whole thing.
All
right.
And
that's
amore.
Oh, no.
Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing the tabella.
Stick handling, so Zack, it just, come on. It's not efficient. It's not, you know, you can't make this quick. You can't make this kind of
can't
pizza quick.
Can't rush the fucker.
Just like a pasta, fast food, that's all.
Anything pretty much with nutritional value, we're just gonna skip. I'm gonna go get some of that spicy taco beef. Just a little bit, you know, I don't want it to overpower.
I think I go like Saskatchewan, Western Canada technique. I'm gonna put the toppings under the cheese so that it stays on, nothing's falling off. We'll see how it works. We don't know. We'll see how it goes. But meat heavy. I'm a big meat fan.
He's soft. Doesn't have this. I got it. Okay. Any young kids out there, you gotta start with a base. Pepperoni, that's gonna be our base.
That's good. Shit. Good rotation. A little bit of Hawaiian style. Big Hawaiian fan.
So you're mixing the pepperoni with the salami and the mushrooms. You're really making a Frankenstein right now. It's the zookeeper special. It's 15 inches of meat. Vegetables. No vegetables.
Whoa! Secret drawer.
Whoa! There's the salami. Yeah, the salami. I was wondering where it was.
Basil?
They're going to have the little red hot pepper next to my pizza because it's going to be a little spicier, you know?
Okay.
A little bit more cheese, some feta, a little blend.
Well, for a few points on the presentation, sorry.
I was thinking about that.
Yeah.
They want something that's going to fill them up.
Fully loaded.
Fully loaded? Nacho dip?
I mean,
are we doing this?
I mean, if you want to put more toppings on your pizza, you can. If you don't want to
do like three slices of salami, that's it.
A three slices of salami? That sounds like a good pizza to me. Yeah, that's all I need. That's all I need. That's all I need. Hard nosed guy. You know?
So when they're done eating yours and they're still hungry, they can have mine.
Are you kidding me?
That's amore.
Everybody, Zach's cutting his pizza. Zach's cutting his pizza. Exactly 90 degrees. The angles are good.
Keep your hands there.
I'm just saying. Zack, I need help.
Okay. If you cut it at 90 degree angles, okay. Two cuts, you get four pieces.
Is that how it works? All right, let's do this. Table seven's up. It's a little tactic. A little barbecue ranch for the boys at home. It's just gonna be the edge that takes me over the top.
When the stars make it through, just like a pasta, fazool, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud.
Yeah, this is pretty solid. I actually like this one a lot. I like the fact that, what is there, about seven different kind of meats on this? So this would be almost a hard one not to like.
We could definitely put it on the menu. A lot of flavor to it between the with the sauces, and I think definitely adding the beef was good.
This pizza is a heart attack waiting to happen, but it's pretty delicious. It's pretty tasty.
This one doesn't have a lot of zip to it. I mean, it's a noble effort, but I like this one. It's got some zip to it.
Good. I like the salsa mix in there with the toppings. I think it has a pretty decent flavor to it, but I definitely have to go with the first one for the spice.
This one has a lot going on at the same time. It's kind of hard to decide, but I think I agree with these guys. The first one is good. It's got a little kick to it. So
back there, the team played well. You know, all the ingredients kicked in together. They all chipped in. You know, did their part for the team, and you know, I think the results speak for themselves.
Tough loss, you know. I was beaten by a better pizza maker today. Pex has a lot of experience, you know, with pizza, and he was clearly better than me today.